The Philippine Senate begins its hearing on the proposed reforms on the pensions for military and uniform personnel. Fiscal managers are concerned spending for the pension system could eat up the country's budget. Ada Perez has the story.
There is an increase in the number of personnel who avail of retirement every time there are discussions on pension reforms for uniformed personnel. This was revealed by the Philippine National Police during the Senate hearing on the proposed reforms in the pension system for military and uniformed personnel, or MUPs.
From 2018 to 2022, there were a total of 18,000 who retired. Out of this 18,
optional retirement.
Yes, sir. Retired, sir, both compulsory and retirement.
Out retirable of that, because of age.
Yes, right. Sir. Both, sir. Out of these 18,000, sir, 12,000 availed the optional retirement, sir.
What?
Yes, sir. 12,000, sir.
That's
65%, sir. It's only, maybe we can display the...
Because of this pension only?
Most probably, sir, there's a correlation between these laws, sir.
The Bureau of Treasury wants MUPs to start receiving their pension only when they reach 57 years old, while Senate Bill No. 284 is designating a 30-year service for voluntary or optional retirement, higher than the existing 20 years of service. The AFP agrees with raising the optional retirement to 25 to 30 years of service. DND Officer in Charge Carlito Galvez Jr. said soldiers appear to be consciously making an effort to do this, as seen in the decrease of the number of retirees in previous years. He said from the 138,000 retirees in 2021, this has gone down to 136,000 in 2022 and 134,000 in March 2023.
Meaning, mukhang nababawasan natin yung mga nag-optional retirement at talagang nakita natin dahil nagdoble po yung sweldo ng mga sundalo, minarapat na nila na mas maganda na ma-maintain na nila yung kanilang status as soldiers na itagpos na po nila hanggang sa compulsory retirement nila. Medyo mahirap sa kasi sa optional retirement, hindi natin na po program. Kasi yung optional retirement is only yun ang medyo decision ng sundalo yun eh. So yun din lang medyo mahirap kasi yung variable, pagka once hindi natin na-determine, predetermine, hindi natin na-forecast, for example, ngayong year na malalaman nila na babaguhin yung law, maybe marami po mag-optional retirement ngayong year or next year.
The Bureau of Treasury also wants to remove the existing policy of automatic promotion for MUPs when they retire.
Ang proposal po namin na if they retire at the current rank po nila.
Parang premyo yan sa isang nag-retire eh, na one rank higher in terms of pension. Parang nagpasalamat ng gobyerno sa kanila, sa kanilang serbisyo na ginawa at nakarating sila sa panahon na yan ng retirement na hindi sila namatay.
Senator De La Rosa pointed out finance managers should use updated data upon seeing that the data used were from 2020 to identify the 9.6 trillion peso unfunded liabilities of the MUP pension system, which comprise 53.4% of the GDP.
Di para bang pinapalabas natin dito na yung MUP ang dahilan bakit magkakaroon din ng fiscal collapse. Please, ituloy natin ito. Let's not do misrepresentation, sir. Let's not paint a very grim picture para mapapasama yung ating mga military and uniform personnel.
Ang sinasabi lang po natin, kung hindi po tayo a-action ngayon, palaki po ng palaki yung pong pensyon na kinakain ng budget. Hindi lang po kami na-alarma na dumalaki ang binabayad sa pensyon, mas na-alarma po kami na yung pong pensyon mas malaki pa po sa ginagastos natin para sa MOE, ng capital outlay ng ating for defense.
Finance managers earlier explained that the national government solely funds the pension of military and uniformed personnel because the MUPs do not pay for contribution, unlike other government employees. Although the Bureau of Treasury favors reforms to be applied to active personnel and new entrants, the proposed legislation only applies to new entrants or those who will become members of the MUP before its effectivity into law. Mandatory contribution will also be imposed. But for Senator Bongo, finance managers should just look for other sources of funding.
Ibahin po natin ang pagkonsidera sa kanila. May exemption naman po dahil sa totoo lang po, iba po ang trabaho nila. Buhay po ang tinatayang nila para mapanatili ang seguridad ng ating bansa. Konsuelo na po sana sa ating military at uniform personnel.
Galvez appeals for a middle ground, while Defense Committee Chairperson Jinggoy Estrada said they will not rush discussions on reforms in the pension system.
The DND and DAP respectfully appeals that the morale and welfare of our soldiers be given due weight. Mere discussions of proposals relating to retirement benefits has already affected the morale and caused uneasiness not only from within the active ranks of the armed forces, but even from our veterans and retirees.
The proposal will be referred to a technical working group and a timetable will be set along with comprehensive studies. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The filing of murder charges against suspended Philippine lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. delayed, according to the Justice Department. That's because several suspects are now refusing to cooperate with a probe into the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo. Teves is deemed the main mastermind in the Degamo killing.
Meaning by lawyered up, they were provided with lawyers by some people who are paying for their lawyers who were not there before. And obviously, there's some people are interested in the statements that they want to give, and now they don't want to cooperate anymore with authorities.
Remulla says the filing of 10 counts of murder against Teves may happen by Wednesday. He also clarifies his previous statement, which appeared to clear the congressman's brother, former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Teves, of involvement in Degamo's killing.
He will always be part of this mix. He is not being cleared of anything. Although he's not yet accused. He has not yet been accused of anything, but he's not cleared of anything. Questions are still being asked about that.
Discussions on Kuwait's entry ban on Filipinos without residency permits set to begin this week. Philippine officials will be traveling to the Gulf nation to seek clarification on what triggered the implementation of the new policy. Without giving details, Kuwait has said it was because of a violation on their labor agreement. The anticipated talks come as more Filipinos get affected by the entry ban.
Parang sinasabi nila, okay, ayaw nyo sa amin, ayaw nyo magpadala ng kasambahay, huwag na kayo magpadala ng kahit anong mga manggagawa. We will always resolve things through diplomacy, but not at the expense of the national pride and honor. Now, after all, safety and welfare din ng ating mga kababayan yan.
Some 40 to 50 Filipinos remain in the conflict towards Sudan. But then according to the Foreign Affairs Department, only less than 20 of them are interested to return home. The Philippine government has so far repatriated nearly 600 Filipinos. Around 46 more left Sudan for another foreign country, and 71 are waiting to leave Port Sudan.
We just hope hindi na sila babalik sa Sudan kasi nakakadismaya naman na after we took all this effort, tapos next year nandun na naman sila. There are positive news about settlement muna of the conflict, but ang reading namin yan, it will always explode every so often.